drama. My name is Derica Blackman. I went to Stanford. I graduated here in 1991, and I'm now the Associate Dean and Director of the Diversity and First Gen Office. I'm originally from Detroit, Michigan. I went to boarding school in East Hampton, Massachusetts, and then I came to Stanford in 1987. And have just moved, lived in Oakland for 19 years, ran Oakland Freedom Schools, Camp Akili, and Leadership Excellence, which are programs for black youth. And our motto then was unapologetically black, and it's still my motto now. So we'll talk a little bit more about that. But one of our panelists here talked about something that's really important to do when you're in a class. What did they say?
Sit up front.
They said, do what?
Sit up front.
Now, if I were to say that we're about to have, who's your favorite hip hop artist?
Ben Gang.
Drake.
Yeah, there ain't no more seats. Sorry.
everybody go down front.
I gotta go, y'all wanna go home, right? Y'all don't wanna be here till five, right? They said I could keep you till five, but y'all move quickly, we can get out of here fast. Move quickly, let's move quickly and get to these chairs. Tell the people that's moving slow, come on, let's go, we got business in the sky. Tell them we got business to handle, black people. We can't be slow, we can't be lollygagging, we can't be half asleep. Black people need to wake up, say, wake up, black people!
Wake up, black people!
Wake up, black people!
Wake up, black people!
When you see somebody sleeping next to you, be like, wake up, black people!
Wake up, black people!
You can't miss this. You cannot afford to miss this, sleep on something else. This is not the day. All right, so first of all, I wanna say thank you. Because it's Saturday, I'm off, you off, and you did not have to be here from 7 a.m. this morning spending all day on a not school day talking about school and intellectual concepts. How many people went to a great workshop? Okay, good, good, good. How many people went to a workshop and was kind of just okay? Okay, how many people went to a workshop and you was like, no, we shouldn't have? Honesty is important. Because part of our problem is people tell us to smile at everything and we don't need to smile at everything. People tell us everything is good and everything they give us is not good. Right? So, let's talk about this. The conference is about blackness and having us think some more about blackness. So, you've been thinking about blackness all day. Tell me what you are. Who are black people? I need a hand. I need a hand. Who are black people? Right here.
We are a race that's trying to overcome.
Race that's trying to overcome. Boom. Right here.
Aboriginals.
Aboriginals. Yes.
We are scientists, engineers, doctors, everything.
Scientists? Wait, hold on. You gotta say it like she said. Scientists, engineers, doctors, everything. Right? Is that right? Yes, yes, yes. Right here. Minorities in America.
And race with a very rich and proud history.
An intelligent race with a very rich and proud history. How many times have you seen somebody tell you that at the movies? You are an intelligent race with a proud history. I saw there was a movie about that, but I didn't go see it. Okay, well, who else? Right here. Unique, yes. All right, good. What else? Anybody else? All right, now, this is who we are, and I'm really proud of you because you know that. Who do they say we are? Criminals, gangsters, thugs, violent. What, baby mama? But because it's such a big room, I'm gonna ask you to amen so we can get it back to order so you can hear people. So I'm gonna use hands, but I want you to participate right here. I'm gonna just go fast.
Uneducated.
What else do they say?
They say we're obnoxious and too bold to speak out too much.
Obnoxious, too bold, speak out too much.
Mm-hmm. Loud and immature.
Loud and immature. Right here.
Ratchet.
Ghetto.
Ghetto.
Statistics. Always late to functions. Not y'all. Huh? Unintelligent. Incompetent. Baby kids. Hood rats. Inferior. Fried chicken. truth and the conditions that we're living in. We're going to talk about how we're depicted in the media. We're going to talk about hip-hop, but we're going to talk about the truth about who we really are. All right, so this is who are we as Black people. This is the three eyes of oppression. Oppression can be internalized, interpersonal, or institutional. Who is this brother here with these glasses on? You better know that or y'all are fighting. Okay, what he says is, who can tell me what this says? Three. One person, right here.
If you're not careful, the newspaper will have you hating the people who are being oppressed and loving the people who are doing the oppressing.
Can you think about one instance where someone has taught you to hate people who are being oppressed and love people who are doing the oppressing?
Yes.
Everybody came to the same person. I don't talk about him. I call him he who shall not be named. So we move it on. I go.
Amen.
Because we got to decide what is worthy of our attention. If you don't get nothing else out of what I tell you today, it is decide what is worthy of your attention. Okay? Common sense deficiency syndrome. So I should tell you that hip hop is my music. I know you thought it was yours, but it's not. I was here at the time when hip hop was born. I came alive when it came alive. I became a teenager when it was fresh and dope. And I don't know what y'all trying to do with it now, but I'm gonna just give you some history so we can get it back on track, okay? Laugh, whatever, all of that. I have only one rule. The rule is, If you keep it real with me, I'll keep it real with you. Can we agree to that?
Yes.
You keep it real with me, I'll keep it real with you. Now keep it real. How many people use the word nigga? We keep it real now.
America and like one
Exactly. This is not Germany. This is America. This genocide happened where? Right here. Go ahead.
Retribution and compensation,
right? Now, let me just be clear with you about something, because sometimes people get very confused. This is not a conversation about hatred. This is not a conversation about hatred. This is an act of love. I love you. Beautiful, amazing, gorgeous, fantastic, brilliant, Black children, I love you, and because I love you, I want you to be disabused of any notion that there is something wrong with you, that there is any problem that you have. Tell this Black man right here, he needs to wake up. We've been asleep too long. Help him out.
Wake up, Black man.
We don't have time to sleep. You can sleep when you die. We have no time. Of history of exploration, of math, of science. I'm going to tell you something. I don't just talk about this because I read about it and I be about it. I went to the Moor's Castle, Alhambra, in Spain. When the black folks came in and took over the castle, they built a lion whose mouth opens and spurts out water every hour. The interesting thing about this is they built the lion before there was electricity. He opens his mouth every hour and spurts out water, like a conch. So when the Europeans took the castle back, they couldn't figure out, like this, how we did it. So they broke it. And they still can't figure it out to this day. You see what I'm trying to tell you? That you have secrets. I'm in a Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, and and when I was here as a student, they would talk about we were a Greek organization. I said, no, I'm not a Greek organization. I'm giving back what the Greeks stole. Do you understand my history, my culture, our ancient mystery systems? That's who we were, and then they tried to imitate that, and now we're trying to imitate them. But I got to move on. There's so much to talk about and not a lot of time. Okay. Before slavery, there were no prisons for black people. Sorry, my bad. Post-traumatic slave disorder right up here. Before slavery, there weren't liquor stores in every corner. Before slavery, the legacy of slavery still impacts us today. We didn't have crack babies or syrup sippers. They made us believe we were inferior and hopeless. Now we celebrate ignorance and violence. Yeah, I'm going to call it just what it is, a celebration of ignorance and violence. We think we're niggas. Who do you want to be? Who taught you to hate your people? and where you come from. I try to take kids to Africa, and I have people telling me, like, I don't want you to get no disease, get beat by no, eat by no lion. And there's no excuse for this kind of ignorance. Because half of Europe is vacationing in Africa. Some of the most beautiful places in the world are on the continent. You know so very little about it. If I asked you to name six countries in Europe, you could do it. If I asked you to name six countries on the continent, some of y'all would struggle. How do you decide what's beautiful? We spend 80, we are, black women spend more on the beauty industry than any other women on the planet, right? Because they have convinced us that it comes in a jar or a package. Then we got this problem. Again, this could be a whole workshop. But let me just break it down to you like this. Pimp is less than a man, period. You ask a man what he thinks about a pimp, he will tell you that is not a man. Right? A pimp is an individual who cannot survive in the world of men, and therefore tries to be a predator on women, particularly women who have men absent in their parenting, because he has no strength, he has weakness, he preys on those who he assumes are weaker than him. He preys on you if your mind is weak. If you are convinced that you are validated by his existence, you will give everything you have to him. I just buried a sister who tried to escape from her pimp 6 months ago. Because it's an epidemic in Oakland, where I worked for many years. And while many of you are already on the right track and you don't have to worry about that actual experience, your mind is still being pimped by the media, by the images, by the ideas that you follow, foster, the people that you like on Facebook, the things that you listen to in your headphones, the TV shows you watch are giving you an idea of who you are. They say you can judge a people by the character of its women. Now we got grand lineage of low character. And here we go. Right? That's three generations. Some of us knew the first picture the best, older folks. Some of us knew the second picture. Right? It's just three generations of questionable character. Because that's how you've been taught to value yourself, right? But let me tell you what's really behind that. Pay attention.
You and you. Fight. You. Put the radio up. Shake your junk. And you hit the brakes.
Uh-oh. Hold on, I'm about to show you. Uh-oh. Hold on, I guess I'm going. One more time.
You and you. Fight. You. Put the radio up. You shake your junk.
What's it say? Who's got the power? There is nothing in any commercial, any advertisement, any television show, any movie that you see that is an accident. It's laid out for you right here. What were the three things they said to do? Fight. What else? Turn up the music. What else? Shake your junk. Hit the brakes is what we do need to be listening to. Fight, turn up the music, shake your junk, because it entertains me. Hip-hop is not made for you. Hip-hop doesn't go platinum if you buy it. You don't even buy it. Hip-hop goes platinum if who buys it?
White
young people. They buy it. Hip-hop, commercial hip-hop, is a safari. It's somebody who wants to see the animals without getting out the car. Oh, look at you. Oh, did you bust a cap in his ass? Can you write a song and tell me about it? Oh, look, is that your bitch right there? young rich niggas. It's a safari. It's not made for you. It's made about you. So somebody can be entertained. So what you've been hearing all day, if you paid attention, is how do we break through this system? How do we become owners of our own media and tell the true story of our community, which look nothing like standing on a bus pole and shaking your junk? There's so much more that what is in our family, in our parents. There's so much more to who we are than what we have seen. You gotta have the power. Otherwise, you just entertainment. Everything that gets you attention does not necessarily get you respect. Repeat that, please.
Everything that gets you attention does not necessarily get you respect.
You gotta know the difference between attention and respect. You get a lot of attention, but that's not the same thing. What folks have been talking to you about today is opportunity. Personally, I don't care whether you go to Stanford or not. I care that you stop believing that you shouldn't be here. You should be here if you want to be. Or you should be wherever it is that you want to go, because if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. There is somebody right now building a prison for everybody without a plan. Do you understand what I'm saying? There's some place for you to go if you have no plan. Wake him up and tell him this tool, we can't just sleep no more. Yeah, it's hard. We gotta wake up, sleep later. Tell the black people, wake up!
Black people, wake up!
Because you need this. Because without a plan, they're building someplace for all of us that don't have a plan. You understand? All right, it's definitely past my time. We can't even get into this today. Attention. Attention, not respect. Do we draw our power from our sexuality or from our ability to make a difference? We have to think about who they're putting in front of us and telling us we should admire. All right, I'm gonna take two questions and then can you clap it up for all the people who work? Show up.